I just want to make sure buyers are aware of the granularity of data that's available to them today in when they're planning and buying their inventory, or when they're creating a media plan, that out of home is comparable to other channels now. We do have that level of granularity that they're used to in digital or TV.
I think it's important for media buyers to understand what targeting and data exists. I would say that there's certain aspects of it, like true tracking, there's no cookies. So you're not able to really know definitively that one person did one action. But on a whole, the data that is available is a lot better, a lot more insightful than anything to do with TV. So it is a medium that they should really appreciate, look at, really dig into, and understand what is possible today.
Because there's much more possible than ever before. So one of the ways that the out-of-home industry is using mobile data and SDK data is to really use that to create a movement model of the entire population. That allows us to understand people passing by the inventory, when they're passing by the inventory, and and apply demographics to that.
And media buyers sometimes have access to first-party mobile data, which they'll also use to map where devices are going, and use that as part of their secret sauce when buying and targeting different panels. So if they see a particular audience, maybe in Times Square, they might trigger a new piece of content based on that profile. So computer vision works by analyzing what a camera sees. It's very similar to like your iPhone camera when you use it, and it draws a box around a face. It's looking for a pattern that it thinks is a face. And then once we detect that face, we're doing facial detection, we're not storing that face. But what we can do is look at it and compare it to an algorithm and understand if that face might be a man or might be a woman. And then also, once you're tracking that face, you're able to detect if it's actually looking at the screen or not. And based on that, you can tell if someone's actually looking at the ad or just standing in front of the ad, which is a great way to look at engagement and see how content is actually performing. So you can use computer vision data to really understand how historical audiences look. A lot of our partners might look at data, you know, a year ago and compare it to today, or they might even look at a trailing past week. Since they're receiving back all the data in real time, they're able to make those adjustments and really see in real time what audience might be there. So you might start to understand that a certain location skews more male during the week and then more maybe female or maybe family on the weekend. And then you can also see how that traffic changes by time of day as well. For publisher first party data, I think the most important is definitely just location. So what is the lat long of this physical screen? And understanding that really allows you to then look at devices, you know, traveling around that screen. Also, most publishers should have access to the data around when their property is open or closed. So that's definitely an indicator of traffic and then who might be there at that time. And you might also look at things like transaction data or total ticket sales, which is somewhat of an older stat, but it's still a useful indicator of total volume of individuals around a certain environment.
I know I've mentioned a lot about mobile data and SDK data and connected car data, and while we are leveraging that as an industry, that's not the only data that we're using. So we are using traditional formats, traditional data as well, such as Department of Transportation, ridership. We have a pedestrian model that we use to understand actual movement of people out there on the streets as well. So all that combined together helps us understand the audience and who's viewing any unit that we audit. You know, opportunity to see is essentially a metric that is everybody out there who essentially has an opportunity to have noted that piece of inventory. And we also apply a likelihood metric to that in digital out of home, which is the ability to move from just being out there, having the opportunity, but to knowing that the likelihood of someone actually having noted that unit or that piece of inventory.
So with opportunities to see, it's based on how many total people could potentially walk by that asset. In our case, we then can also see when that person potentially looks at the asset, which would really allow us to true up the real audience that observed an ad at that time. So when using computer vision data, it allows you to be somewhat predictive in understanding what audience has historically been there. So when we work with partners, we have APIs that can actually feed that data in predictively and actually tell you what we estimate that total audience impression to be before it happens. And then after a campaign's actually run, we have what we call an accountability handshake. We're able to actually say exactly how many people were present.
While we are leveraging mobile data and connected car data, as I said, it's all aggregated and anonymized. We're looking at a census block group level, so we don't get down to the personal identifiable information. So we're able to use that level of data to model out, as I said, the movement and then ultimately the demographics of these neighborhoods and ultimately the movement of the people past any of the inventory. In terms of standardizing, I feel like that's essentially what our role is at Geopath, to provide this standard currency across the digital out-of-home industry to allow buyers and sellers to transact against.
And I'd add that in the case of companies like Quividi, where we're using computer vision or something that's more advanced, we typically see that it adds more value to the partners we work with because they're able to generate even more specific metrics like attention time, and that provides more value back to them. And as an industry, I think it's important that there's platforms in place that can ingest multiple sets of data, which is very similar to digital. When you target, you look at things like, how do I use a ComScore pixel, a Nielsen pixel? How do I then report against viewability using IAS or Moat? So you're not just using one vendor. It might be first-party data. It's definitely viewability data and demographic data. And then stack those all together in a very easy and efficient system as well. It's not like there's one data piece that you can use. There's actually a very vibrant data story that each publisher comes to. So that might be, transportation data. It might be how many flights this particular area had or how many purchases a store had. And that helps you better understand the actual total reach versus some of the more impression-based metrics that exist out there.
Right, and I would say more data is better, right? It just helps create a clearer picture of the story. So as long as it's big enough and scalable enough for us, that's all that matters.